Yes, sir.
Any event, you touched on the documents, we can get the doctor's attention.
Yes.
During the ballot, and we see the athlete hurt, can we stop the clock time and then ask the doctor to come on in and check the fight?
Sure. I mean, there's nothing wrong with getting a professional opinion on an assessment for a fighter, yes. Right. If you think there's, you know, I don't know what it is, you think he's going into an asthma attack, or you really think he's hurt, yes. Time, anything generally more than 5 seconds, call time. Have the doctor come in, make an assessment, and we go from there.
Is it okay if I, okay, normally, second round, I normally get both of the corners.
You let them know what
round
two.
But the third round, what I start to do, I go over it right to their face. It's the third round, and I go right there, and I have a face-to-face.
Why?
It's just something that I started to do.
Why?
I let
Who wants
them
to
know.
See you in the third round?
Yeah.
Just stay in the center of the ring. And just, if that's what you want to do, three. Sometimes the announcer says three. I mean, either Everton, they know it's only three. Yeah, you don't have to get in anybody's face. Nah. Way too much time.
Yeah.
Just stay in the middle. It's not about you. Any other? Yes, at the top.
All right, sir. Is there anything that you know now that you wish you knew when you started refereeing? Like maybe to call it a professional experience? You learned a lot.
I had some tremendous mentors, and I'm glad of that. I had Mr. David Jordan, Curtis Rollins, and Sam Garrett. Jordan especially, I called him a lot on a regular. I mean, I almost became part of his family, but I would do a show and make a mistake and, you know, But he was a guy that I could call and tell him about a situation. And I think at one point I used to kind of beat myself up a little bit. I'm my worst. But I just feel like for this sport, the athletes deserve my best. Nothing less than my best. And even after, if other people complain, I mean, I would really jump on myself really hard. But the point is, if you do jump on yourself hard, don't stay too long. You know, hey, 30 minutes, beat yourself up, and then move on. So that's one thing I probably would do differently. I used to beat myself up for too long. Generally, at the end of a show, I go home, and I'm rewinding how I did that day or that night. Asking myself questions like, Brent, did you do your best for that athlete? Did you stop it too late? Did you stop it too early? Did you do your best? And if I can go to bed knowing I did my best, I'm done. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Cool. All right. 8 counts. Okay. True or false? Question? 3-1 round. Bounce over. 4 8-counts in the bout, the bout's over. True or false?
In the amateur, yes. 3 8-counts in a round, fight's over. 4 in a bout, fight's over. Yes. Now that's like a rule question. Today I'm not really dealing with rules.
Okay.
You got to spend time with your rule book to pick up on that. Today is just information.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Are you speaking on judging as well, or are you just going to speak on referee?
Today I'm just dealing with referee.
Okay.
Yeah. Judges, they can do the seminar or something. Another point that helped me out in my early days, I decided early on, you know what, I want to be one of the best in this area. I wasn't really comparing myself to anybody else. What I would do, I would compare myself to myself. For example, am I better than I was 6 months ago? Am I better than I was a year ago? So I'm constantly improving, constantly tweaking. If we all had to wear a white shirt, I'm gonna make sure mine is wrinkle-free, iron and crispy. Mark can tell you. You know, all of ours might be white, but I'm gonna make sure mine is a little bit whiter, a little bit more. You know, all right? The other goal was not just to be one of the best in this area, but to be one of the best in the region. DC, Maryland, Virginia, Delaware, I was able to achieve that. Then went to national tournaments.